Hey guys, in this video I'm going to show you two simple mount escapes, probably something you've seen before, but I'm going to make the point of using the fifth limb of jiu-jitsu, which is going to be our head. By moving our head out of the way when we're mounted, we're going to be able to set up our hips a little bit better to escape more easily against stronger opponents.
All right guys, let's take a look at the position. So these are two of my favorite ways to escape the mount, and we're just going to add one little detail. This is something that I like to use myself. So if I have my partner in the mount, and let's say the trap and roll, for instance. So he's got one hand in the collar. I isolate this side. A lot of times I chop at the elbow, control the back or the shoulder. And it's not wrong to do it this way. When I step over it, I just go from here. If his weight isn't balanced nicely, and I'm nose to nose with him, and I trap this, he's gonna fall. But because this guy's already a blue belt, he already knows the trap and roll. So it can be very difficult to sweep someone when you're nose to nose with them. So when I take time to lock this side down and step over, it might not be enough from here. So what I want to do is focus on getting my head off the center line. So if I'm going to do a trap and roll, he feels that foot coming, and I just hold here. But what I'm going to do from there is I'm going to move my head way off to the side, similar to how a boxer would slip a punch. So instead of lifting my hips and turning first, I'm going to move my head to the side so I can look in his ear. Now I hit my roll here. It's gonna change the angle of his hips just a little bit, make it a little bit easier. So while I'm down there, I take my time to collect those things. I step over the foot, I have the arm, and I just make sure I'm not gonna get choked. When I'm ready, especially if he does try to get that second hand in there, that's when I move my head offline, and I come up, obviously make sure to posture so you don't get choked anyways. The other one, using the same principle of moving my head offline, is I like to, normally when the mount has already started to take place, is use two hands to frame on the hips, nice and low so I don't get armbar. I like to bump from here and turn. Again, I'm gonna get my nose off to the side so our ears are lined up. But let's say he had a hand in the collar here. I'm framing him away so he can't reach the other side to choke me. And when I do that, again, I can go either side from here, but I'm going to move my head offline first. Now from here, I can bump. I can usually get a butterfly hook in, start the re-guard, okay? So two hands is nice. Sometimes I'll only have one hand because I need to make sure this other hand's not going to choke me. So I have the hand there. Again, I'm going to move my head way off center line. Now I can hit my shrimp. Start getting my butterfly hooks in, hit an elbow escape. So that's just something to think about. All of those mount escapes that we kind of know already, try to get your head offline really quick. Your back will stay flat for the most part. Then hit your shrimp, get to your side, give it a try, see what you think.
Thanks for watching, guys. If you liked the video, please hit like, comment below with any questions. Follow me on Instagram @Ben_Eggly. Thanks.